Dear friends, wish you all the peace and joy of the season. Today I have come with the theme, God pitched his tent among his people. The Son of God became incarnate and dwelt among his people to instill the feeling that all are brothers and sisters and children of the Supreme God. Pope Benedict reflects on the mystery of the Incarnation, calling it the original gift of Christmas. He says, "On that holy night, God becoming flesh, wanting to become a gift for his people, gave himself for us." God has made his only begotten Son a gift for us, taking our humanity to give us his divinity. Here we find the model of our giving, because our relationships, especially the most important ones, are driven by the free gift of love. The Incarnation is the Word becoming flesh and is central to the Christian faith. The word flesh in the Hebrew context indicates the person as a whole, the whole person. Thus it signifies the particular time and place in which Christ became man. It shows further that he cares for the particular circumstances and culture of everyone's life. This is to say that Jesus of Nazareth touches humanity in their concrete reality and in whatever situation that one is. God took the human condition to heal us from all that separates us, to bind us from all that blinds us, so that we can call him Abba, Father, and truly be his children. It is important then to recover the amazement before this mystery, God. The true God, creator of all, has come as a man in our streets, entering the time of man to communicate his own life, says Pope Benedict. Incarnation therefore defines the divine love for his creation. It is an articulation of God's way of connecting himself to his own. Left to itself, the humanity would lose its way. It would perish. Pope Benedict says, "Incarnation shows us the unprecedented realism of divine love." Friends, this action of God is not a view to be looked at, but a mystical bond to be felt and lived out. It's a mystery that has become part of human life, and we as Christians are called to be ambassadors witnessing to this great truth. The life of Christ is a mystery to get immersed into, for it has taken on itself the helplessness of the world, the helplessness of humanity. By this very gesture, God chose to join the humanity in its simplest form, becoming a member of a human family, sharing the human experiences, teaching, healing, sharing human friendship, getting engaged in the public ministry, performing miracles, yet staying connected to his Abba Father until the last moment. An expression of total acceptance we see here. Therefore, friends, faith should not be limited to the mere feelings and emotions, to pilgrimages and processions, but must enter into the heart of human realities, feeling the pulse of our everyday life. Pope Benedict emphasizes that faith has a fundamental aspect with affects, not only the mind and the heart, but the entirety of our lives. And in this child, he continues, the Son of God, we can recognize the true face not only of God, but the true face of humanity. Therefore, our call is to open ourselves to the grace in action, finding each other as a brother or a sister. The image of Jesus being born in a straw-filled manger must help us open our eyes to the millions on the streets. In the cold of the night, without a roof over them to protect. Our faith in God and our worships without paying any heed to the struggling creation becomes mere rituals. It is soulless and empty. Love is not limited to one's own family either, to one's own relatives, community or nation. Love overlooks all the boundaries and reaches out to all creation. Creation is closely linked to God's heart because it is His handiwork. Along with incarnation also comes the people with every nation with its cultures. Incarnation finds its true place when we accept, regard, share and care for one another as members of the same family. A world that considers these values as secondary disregards life in its entirety. We share in a great variety of cultures, traditions, language, wealth and knowledge. Since all these are created by the same God, our differences shouldn't be a threat but a blessing. The differences must not add to the discord and divisions, but enhance our living together and our works together. May the Creator God, who made the world in His deep passion, uphold us as His own despite all our limitations. Amen.